Alexis Pitting.
Oh, Alexis Fargo, what is happening here? Alexis Fargo at the end of the warm-up lap on the factory Aprilia. Big, big story emerging here then in Japan. And we've lost the man third in the World Championship. Revs up. Lights out, and we're underway here at MotoGP Japan 2022. Really good start from pole position by Mark Marquez. Likewise, the man on the front row, Brad Binder, who'll get the whole shot. The South African sweeps up the inside of Marquez. What has happened here to Valentino Spargo on the factory Aprilia? An absolute nightmare, a disaster for the Spaniard.
It's Brad Binder who leads it then out of turn one. He got past Mark Marquez into the first corner. I thought I saw Valentino Spargo shaking his head on the warm-up lap, but he has come into the pit as Zarco now goes past Mark Marquez into second place.
What happened to Aleix Espargaró? He drops that factory Aprilia. So desperate he was to get in this Grand Prix. What happened to Aleix Espargaró on that warm up? I'm sure Simon Crafar hot on the gates, trying to find out exactly what was the issue.
Look, Jack Miller.
Jack Miller getting aggressive. He picks up Oliveira and Marquez down into the 90 degree corner. Mark Marquez then gets
pushed back
from pole to fourth.
Yeah, he's struggling in this opening lap of the Grand Prix because Oliveira is all over the back of him.
Quartararo and Bagnaia made no progress. They started 9th and 12th respectively. That's where they came over the line. Here comes Bagnaia, tight inside line.
No way through.
Trying to get through Marini. Marini's just too good on the brakes, isn't he? Into that turn number 5. Miller's gone for it on the inside. Jack Miller's been superb on the brakes down at that 90 degree corner. On the last lap, on the first lap, he got Oliveira and Marquez into that turn number 11. This time around, his victim is Brad Binder. Miller off into second. Martinez that still leads, but here's where Jack Miller has been so menacing. Oh, Miller's just absolutely awesome on the front end of that factory Ducati. Although he's in hot, he's in hot. They rub side by side the two factory Ducatis. Miller will have the advantage on Jorge Martin coming into the final sector through turns 12 and 13. This has been a superb start by Jack Miller to this Japanese Grand Prix. He started in 7th place. He's worked his way to the front now. Miller leads at the start of lap 4 here in Japan at 1:45.472. Miller on a different level right now. Here comes the beast then on the inside of Bagnaia. Safely through down the hill into turn number 11. Although Bagnaia just says, no, you're not having that. Straight back underneath him through the 90 degree corner. Great fight further back down the field then. There's points up for grabs though here, isn't there, for Aleix Espargaró? And that'll be a real good rescue mission, a right good salvage job after all the drama that happened. This was the start of the problems. Right off the start of the warm-up lap then, issues for Aleix Espargaró.
I think he knows straight away, doesn't he, that something's wrong. He's got hand up immediately.
Yeah, I don't know if there's some kind of issue with the gearbox there or something majorly went wrong, didn't it? Here goes the beast, and on the inside of Bagnaia. Bagnaia had the left foot off the foot peg there, didn't he? Breaking for that first gear, turn number 10.
Hey, this is the move that Bastianini put in on the inside. Very nearly contact there. Look how close that was. You can see what Paolo Civatti and Davide Tardozzi think of that.
Blimey, there might be a red flag. We could have a red flag here. We could have a red flag.
He needs to get off the circuit.
Takuya Tsuda, the Suzuki wildcard, well, the replacement for Juan Mir. He's got
to
get off.
He's
that.
Not seen
he
it.
Doesn't realise that
off.
Bike is on
He'll
fire.
Be feeling on his feet.
Are going to get so hot now. Jump off it, Tsuda-san, quickly. A major, major technical malfunction then, to say the least, for the factory Suzuki. But Bagnaia by far has got the best speed. Oh, that's lovely.
That's,
that's brilliant by Pekka Bagnaia. That was a superb move going through that third gear, turn 12. There was nothing that the beast could do about that one. So now he claws back one very precious point on Quartararo in this championship charge. Binder has got through on Martin, then he's got that second place. We knew the move was going to come. This was his move on Martin late on. Oh, that was close.
You can see him taking a slightly wider entry there, and as he turns it tighter, Martin taking what is probably a normal line for him, really, through turns 1 and 2, but Binder able to turn it tighter and go through.
Pekka Bagnaia's crash! Can you believe it? What an error by Pekka Bagnaia! Head in hands for the Italian on the last lap. What drama here in Motegi. We lost Aleix Espargaró on the warm-up lap, a technical problem for the factory Aprilia, and Pekka Bagnaia has blown it on the last lap. He goes for the inside move on Fabio Quartararo. He almost collected Fabio Quartararo as well there. Here comes Jack Miller, though, the Aussie. It's Miller magic in Motegi. What a ride by the Factory Ducati man. He takes a fourth win of his MotoGP career. The stunning late charge by Brad Binder secures him second place. His first podium since the opening night in Qatar. Jorge Martin takes third, his first rostrum since Barcelona. Marquez is fourth from pole. Oliveira fifth. Marini in sixth place. Vinales takes seventh. Quartararo comes over the line in eighth place and increases his world championship lead after a last lap disaster for Ducati's Pecco Bagnaia. There was a late Espargaró. He comes over the line 16th place. That will feel like the best victory of this man's career. Jack Miller was just completely untouchable. Absolutely stunning. We get the burnout as well. He's not worried about the engine mileage, is he, or over revving the motors.
Yeah, or rear tyre life.
Yeah. Brilliant stuff, that by Jack Miller. Contrasting fortunes then for the Ducati Lenovo team. In our full dry practice session here on Friday, Miller was the top dog, and he's the top dog again here when it mattered most on Sunday afternoon. Astonishing performance by Jack Miller. He just was dominant. The six different race winner.
Mr. Abdul Rahman Almani, board member for the FIM, congratulates Jack Miller. The Aussie was on another planet today. As Bagnaia fluffed his lines, it was Miller time here in Motegi.